tablespoons of this great value fat free half and half, and half a tablespoon of my Jordan Skinny Syrups Caramel Pecan. Super good. Love this stuff. I get it at Burlington Coat Factory. In my cute little Hello Kitty cup. So this ends up being one smart point for the two tablespoons of the fat-free half and half.
Good morning, guys. Sorry about that video this morning. My voice was a little weird. It was 6 a.m. I was just getting up. So let me show you what I have for
lunch. Okay, so for breakfast, which I'm going to have at work, I'm having two of these Eggo low-fat waffles. Two of these is 4 points. I'll top it off with some blueberries, and then I have my Walden Farms sugar-free syrup that I just take with me. Mid-morning snack, I'll probably either have this Light and Fit Greek yogurt for 2 points, or my cheese. I like to give myself options, like, depending on what I feel like. I also have these apple crisps. At first, I was like, oh, great, like, you know, who knows how much sugar is added into this, but they're actually just apples. Like, the ingredients, it's just apples, and it's awesome, and they kind of have, like, a great crunch to them. They're like chips. I really like these. Got them at the 99-cent store. 99-cent store never lets me down. I love that place, so I'll have that either mid-afternoon snack, mid-morning snack, like I said, depending how I feel. For lunch, I have, you can't really see it, but this is my meal prep. I have 4 ounces of ground turkey, some green beans, and half of a sweet potato. I believe the turkey is 4 points or 3 points. I'll let you guys know. Obviously, the green beans are 0. Half of the sweet potato, I want to say, is 3 points, but I will double check. And in here, of course, is my 0-point soup that I made last night, which I love. Just, it's a filler. It's good. I love that stuff. So really trying to stay on 30 points today. I don't do the Weight Watchers freestyle, and I'll explain that to you guys shortly. I'm currently doing smart points. I have my own way of doing it, so continue to watch if you're interested. Got back home from work. It's about 4:24. I'm going to my cycling class at 5:30 today. That's the perks of getting off at 4, is I get to take all the awesome classes at the gym. So before I go to the gym, I actually make myself this little turkey wrap just to get some kind of energy protein in my body, and I have the points for it. So let me show you how I make that. Extreme Wellness Wraps. I love these. Okay, they're awesome, and they're only one smart point. By the way, this whole kind of sandwich or roll up wrap, whatever you want to call it, is 3 points in total. So it's 1 point for the wrap. And then I put a half a tablespoon of light Miracle Whip for 0 points. 4 slices of this Great Value thin sliced turkey breast for 1 point. 1 slice of this Kraft Singles 2% American for 1 point as well. Unfortunately, as we all know, they stopped making the fat-free of the singles. I mean, at least that's what I've heard. If you guys know of any place that still sells the fat-free ones, let me know. I would love to get my hands on them. Not that I mind wasting 1 point on cheese, but, you know, I'd rather not. So this is it. Totally worth the 3 points. Gives me the energy I need during cycling, because we go hard during cycling. I'll see if I'm able to film any of it. Probably not, because I get a little awkward, but yeah. Okay, so I do want to take the time to kind of explain
why I don't use the real Weight Watchers app. It has nothing to do with being against Weight Watchers. If anything, I think it's fantastic. It's, I think, one of the best ways to get healthy, because I don't want to call it a diet, because it's not a diet, it's more of a lifestyle. I feel like it's realistic, it's fantastic. It's just, unfortunately for me, financially, I'm gonna go for the option that works better for me. So there's an app called iTrack Bites. I'm sure you've heard of it. So unfortunately, it doesn't have Freestyle on it just yet. They're still on Smart Points, which, I mean, has worked for many people. So as long as it has Smart Points, I'm gonna continue with that. So the app is called iTrack Bites, like I mentioned. And instead of paying monthly for the service, you pay a one-time fee. I believe when I bought it, I think the app was $2.99. Now I think it's $4.99, which still beats, I think it's $20 a month for Weight Watchers. I'm not absolutely sure. Don't hold me to it. If you know of a cheaper way to do it, let me know. I'm interested. It's just what works for me. The app is super user-friendly. It has everything that the Weight Watchers, well, not everything, but it gets the basics of Weight Watchers Smart Points. Now, I did Weight Watchers in like 2009, I think. And back then it was still Points Plus. And that, I didn't do it for that long because I was very young. I think I had like a part-time job and I just couldn't. And I mean, I was like 20. I was already skinny. If only I was that weight now, you know, right? But whatever, moving right along. And it worked for me on Points Plus. I think I lost 10 pounds in 1 month, which for a lot of people might not seem like a lot, but for me, I was like, holy cow, this is awesome. Because you're still eating. You're still eating foods you want to eat. It's more about portion control and self-control and discipline, which I really personally appreciate. So it's not that I have anything against Weight Watchers. If anything, I want to do Freestyle because I follow so many of these YouTubers who I really look up to and give me a lot of inspiration. I listen to it all day. They're what inspired me to start my channel. So I am curious to try Freestyle. I would love to try it. I love that there's a lot of 0 points foods. It does hurt me that I think you only get like 23 points a day or 20, I believe. I like having my 30 points. But then again, there's all this 0 point food. So, you know, it all cancels each other out. But yeah, so I'm currently doing iTrack Bites. If you're still interested in hearing how I do it, keep watching my videos. I do my, you know, I'm not perfect. I'm not perfect every day. There are days that I'm like, oh, I just want to eat that or whatever. I'm not counting points today. But that's why I created this channel, so that I stop doing that. And I'm more, you know, I have more accountability. I need to be like, you know, I'm going to film everything I eat and I'm going to vlog about this so I can watch my journey. I want you guys to watch me lose like 20 pounds so I can get to my goal weight. Right now, I weighed myself this morning. I weigh 169.6 pounds. My goal is to be 150. Now, I know that that's not like for my BMI or whatever. That's not like where I'm supposed to be at. But in the past when I've been 150, I felt gorge. I felt great. I was like, yeah, ready to take on the world. Like I said, maybe on a chart, that's not what I'm supposed to weigh, but I know that that's where I feel good. Now, if we can go past that, that would be just amazing. But my goal is to be 150. So let's make it happen, people. And I'm going to stop talking because I got to get to cycling. So I just watched my video back and realized that I did not go a little bit deeper into iTrack Bites. So the reason I like it is because it has a calculator, it has a recipe builder, it has all like those kind of things you would need that make, that facilitate having Weight Watchers, being on Weight Watchers. The scanner, like I said, recipe builder, oh, the restaurant guide, which is, it's a lifesaver, or a life ruiner. Yeah, so it's a really great app. Give it a try. It's only $3.99 or $4.99. I'm sure we've all spent $4.99 on stupider stuff before. But, I mean, if you're already doing Weight Watchers, fantastic. Keep doing it. Work it, girl or boy. But, yeah, just something if you are trying to kind of find a more affordable way of doing Weight Watchers or a Weight Watchers type lifestyle, then try iTrack Bites. I really like it. It's worked for me. Let's hope it works even better, you know, in this coming weeks, because I need to get on it, because this last week I was just awful. I just ate whatever the heck I wanted, and now I'm paying for it, because like I said, when I got on the scale this morning, I was like, ooh, that is not 2 pounds more than I was last week. So it shows that when you follow your points, the results follow. Like, they're there. You see it on the scale, and it feels so good. But then, like I said, this morning when I got on, I was like, oh God, but whatever. All we can do is continue to move forward. Well, hi, I just got to the gym, taking my pre-workout. So I can have all my energy during my class. It really helps. I know a lot of people are against it, but man, that stuff really helps. So I come to Total Woman Gym and Day Spa. I don't know if you guys have one wherever you may be at, but it is honestly the best gym I have ever personally belonged to. And I've pretty much been to all of them. LA Fitness, 24 Hour Fitness, Curves, name another one. Oh, Planet Fitness, which is really cool, but they just have no classes, like no real classes. So classes at 24 Hour were really good, but that gym is just always, always at all times so crazy busy. And it's just kind of intimidating going to the weights sometimes, because obviously there's like these big old meatheads. Not that I'm against that. Go for it. Do whatever you want to do. But the great thing about my gym is that it's a regular gym, but it's only for women, which I love. The classes are great. It's super nice inside. It's just fantastic. I can't film inside because I don't want to be weird, but let me show you a picture. Hello! Just got back from my workout. As you can see, I'm very red and sweaty. I did stop at Smart and Final on my way back, because there's one right next to the gym. Could have had more perfect placement. So I got this big old bag of broccoli for dinner tonight, and for probably dinner tomorrow. These, I think they're shiitake mushrooms. They're so good. 0 points. 0 points for the broccoli too. And I just mixed these with like some garlic and a little bit of low sodium soy sauce. Really good. Some chicken. Some sugar-free pancake syrup for my low-fat waffles in the morning, because I ran it on my Walden Farms and they didn't have any at Smart and Final, which is usually where I get it. So I don't know what's going on, Smart and Final, but it's all right. And then these, super weird, but hear me out, baby snacks. Now, these are super good, and I'm not kidding. What's the serving? 16 pieces, which is, they're like little Cheetos. And it comes out. There's been in the past, there are some that are 0 points and some that are 1 point. I believe the ranch ones are 1 point, but they're so good because I love chips. I love crunchy things. I love everything bad for me. And it's like, if I could find a way to still snack, but it not be as bad for me and super low points, I'm going to do it even if it's baby food. Judge me. It's good. Try it. Don't knock it till you try it. Little Crunchies Ranch. Do it. Yeah. All right, time to make some dinner. Okay, so I just want to show you guys how I personally roast my broccoli. It's super tasty, really easy too, and it's just a way to make your broccoli not so boring. So step one, I don't like big old pieces of broccoli. I don't know why. So I just kind of cut them up with my kitchen scissors to make them a little bit tinier. Maybe not the most beautiful way, but it is what it is. I don't like those pieces either. Okay, now that those are all cut up kind of in smaller pieces like I want, I add about a tablespoon of this extra virgin olive oil from Sprouts. It's really great. I'm gonna do that. Awesome. And then I give it kind of a shake like this. You might lose some in the process. It's okay. My countertop is clean. Don't worry. See, like this one's too big. I prefer it to go smaller. Just kind of so they're all coated. Should have grabbed a bigger bowl, but that's okay. All right. And then the best seasoning of all time, this McCormick all-purpose pink Himalayan sea salt black pepper and garlic. It's awesome. I use it on everything. I'm going to use it on the chicken in just a second. So I just kind of dash that on there. Cool. Beautiful. Give it a shake. A little bit more, and that's it.
So I have this awesome little toaster oven that my mom got me when I moved in here. I would use the regular oven, but it kind of heats up the whole house, and this little toaster oven just gets the job done. When she first got it for me, I was like, I'm never going to use this, but honestly, I use it almost every single day. So I just lined the little sheet pan. It comes with some aluminum foil so I don't have to wash it later. And then those broccolis that I just mixed, just kind of lay them on there. Spread them out. Oops. Like I said, you might lose some. And then I turn this to bake. I usually put it about 450, go to stay on. And I just put those suckers in there for about 20, 30 minutes. You just gotta watch it and see. I personally like them really crispy. So while that's cooking up, I'll go ahead and start making the chicken. This little girl won't stop complaining. So let me stop making dinner so I can feed you, dear. She acts like we starve her, but anything. She probably should get on a kitty Weight Watcher diet.
Full disclosure, I don't starve my cat. If anything, she probably eats too much. She's just a big whiner and kind of dramatic, which is why we get along so well and why I adopted her. Love her to death.
Okay, so I just started off by putting half an onion in here, just sauteing it. A little bit, get a little bit of caramelization. Gonna go ahead and add the chicken in there, and then just, you know, heat it up, pan fry it. Well, not fry, not deep frying anything, people. I used a little bit, of course, of this PAM organic extra virgin olive oil. Onions, I'll add my chicken thighs in there, and I use the Himalayan sea salt black pepper and garlic blend again. So I'll let you know how that turns out. You guys, this smells so good. I can't wait to eat it. And our broccoli is coming along here. See how it starts getting a little crispy on the ends? Looking good. Just a little tip, right before I'm about to serve dinner, I just put this on broil for like the last 2 minutes because, you know, the top gets hot, and then it just makes the top really nice and crispy. Be careful though, because I have forgotten in the past and then ended up with some really burnt vegetables. It was very sad. So just, if you won't remember, like put a little timer for yourself. So, super good. Look at this, you guys. It looks so good. I'm very proud of myself. So the broccoli is zero, but I am going to count 1 point for the olive oil. And then the chicken, it's 5 ounces of chicken, dark meat. So I'm going to count that. When I checked on my tracker, it said each ounce was a point. So this would technically be 5 points. So 5 plus 1, so 6 point dinner. So that might even leave me with some room for dessert. All right, guys, time for dessert. So I have this Arctic Zone banana pudding ice cream. Half a cup is only 3 points. So I just put it in this bowl with one banana. Should be good. Wish I had some Walden Farms chocolate syrup, but that's okay. Another amazing find from the 99 cent store. I used to buy Arctic Zone at Sprouts, and it would be almost $4 for this little container. Worth it though, because it's super good, but Nothing beats the 99 cent store, guys.
All right, so after that dessert, I am left with 2 smart points for the day. I don't think I'm gonna use them. I think I'm okay, but yeah, thanks for joining me today. I really appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed it. Let me know if there's anything else you wanna see. And I'm gonna keep doing these blogs, and please watch. Thank you.